Hello, this is Assemblymember John Perez, chair of the Assembly Democratic Caucus. This week, I join my colleagues and millions of Californians, and indeed millions of people across the United States, with their eyes fixed on our state, in expressing my disappointment with the Supreme Court's decision on Proposition 8. Over the past year, our state and nation have witnessed same-sex couples marrying and strengthening their families and communities. Unfortunately, the Supreme Court was forced to render a difficult decision on an issue where passions run high on both sides. Sadly, a court that was with us a year ago was unable to be with us on Tuesday. I am heartened by Justice Moreno's dissenting opinion and his eloquent words that even a narrow, limited exception to the promise of full equality strikes at the core of the guarantee of equal treatment. In just over a year, more than five states have agreed with those words and recognize marriage equality within their borders. Those states are poised to be joined by more. The decision is deeply felt by millions of people across the state and this country that see California as a beacon of hope. As disappointing as the Supreme Court's decision on Proposition 8 is, we must remember that it marks one moment in a long struggle, and I do not feel deterred. As Martin Luther King said, the arc of history is long, but it bends towards justice. I remain optimistic that through our hard work and dedication, California will strike down these temporary impediments on our long journey. But it is up to us. As Harvey Milk intimately understood, our fate is in our hands, and we win only when we work for it. We also need to remember that although marriage is an important goal, it is not the only challenge we face. The battle against inequality has many fronts. Good, patriotic Californians who are serving honorably in the armed forces, including those who are Arabic translators, are being discharged based solely on their sexual orientation. Gay Californians are still being denied domestic partner benefits by entirely too many employers. The HIV and AIDS rates in African American and Latino communities is far higher than in their white counterparts. These realities remind us that we're not merely fighting to take advantage of a tax exemption or for Social Security benefits or even a marriage certificate. We're fighting for something much more significant than that. We're fighting for a dream shared by any oppressed minority group, to be free, to live one's life without unjust interference, to be treated with dignity and respect, and to be equal in the eyes of others and the law. Regardless of the court's decision this week, we have a responsibility to the people of California, especially those who are hurt by this proposition, to continue to fight and achieve full equality for all. And while this decision is a disappointing setback, it reminds us that we have much more work ahead of us. We must continue to gain allies and strength. We need to continue pushing forward on every front. We know in our hearts that victory will come. We also know that we get closer to victory with every door we knock on, every phone we ring, every voter we register. We are not the first community who's had to stand up and fight for our rights. But building on the example of others who came before us, our day of justice is not far off. So let's get to work. This has been Assemblymember John Perez.